Here, I would take the pleasure to introduce you to the team. Myself, Megha Tak from DICT Gandhinagar.
I'm Dhwani Shah from Vitsalani Goa campus.
I'm Shivani Shrastha from NIT Jamshedpur.
I'm Praveen Kumar Mannepalli from KLC Vijayawada.
Hearty good morning to everyone. This is Setu Saxena from SGS ITS Indore.
My name is Neeraj and I am from IIT DAV Indore.
Hi, I am Dasanand from NITK Surat.
I am Hardik from SVNIT Surat.
Thank you all. We'll begin with what basically is Flickr and what is the overview of the entire project. Flickr is an affordable interactive device for the communication between students and instructors in a classroom and remote environment. Basically, it has been developed in order to prevent the time that is getting wasted in taking up the student doubts or attendance, etc. in classes. Like there are 300 to 400 students in mostly classes and colleges all across India. So basically, to prevent that human error also in case of taking quizzes, etc., where the instructor has to go through a long process of doing the marking and keeping a record of all the things. This particular device is helping in order to make that process faster. It is developed with the aim to collect all the attendance, take quizzes and solve student doubts without spending much time and preventing human errors. Collecting student doubts is through the functionality of raise hand. The project has the scope of being developed as a web-based system to reduce the installation and configuration process. The Flickr interns team also worked on the web-based design of Flickr software, whereby the software will run only through a web browser and you don't need any kind of installation process. The objective of our internship work constituted four major tasks, which I explained here. First is Python serial utility, which is for the communication between the actual Flickr hardware and the receiver, which is connected to the instructor machine. The receiver works perfectly now for 200 Flickrs maximum, which has been configured. If there are more than that students, we need to put multiple receivers. So the task has been successfully completed. Second was creating a GUI installer to install the Flickr software in remote centers so that you don't have to go through the long process of downloading different packages from the internet. There will be one software that will install and uninstall the various packages needed for Flickr software automatically just by a next press, which has also been completed successfully. The integration of OpenOffice into Flickr desktop application and implementing those features into OpenOffice as well. That means it was a two-way process, integrating OpenOffice into Flickr and integrating Flickr into OpenOffice. That was so that the instructor doesn't have to change slides again and again and skip between the software and OpenOffice. So that task has also been done. The web-based Flickr application, which gives a web-based user interface and you can access the entire software from the browser rather than going through the installation process and then accessing it. The team has been working on making a web-based application. After these four tasks, we'll explain each of the tasks that we did separately. The first one being Python serial utility, on which myself, Megha Tak and Dhwani Shah have worked on. The modules that we have used are Flickr configuration, Flickr attendance, quizzes and raise hand, which have been integrated and it has been put in an object-oriented form now, so that other file, you only have one executable file rather than in the previous case we had a lot many executable files. The commands that are used to configure the USB when you connect it to the laptop, like you have to put some commands like sudo ln -sf and all these commands, they have been integrated into Python only, so you don't have to run those commands separately. The XML files, which were earlier manually written, like you have to write 1, 2, 3, 4, all the number of Flickrs. If there are 200 students, you'll have to manually print those 200 Flickrs into the XML, are now getting generated automatically. Basically the aim to make this Python serial utility was not for the instructor or somebody to use, but for the testing point of view, so that the receiver and Flickr hardware are working properly in synchronization to each other. And this now becomes a standalone utility which you can test from even the keyboard, like you can press different options that you want, whether you want to take attendance or quiz or raise hand. And then you can check whether the receiver is working properly for all of them or not. the architecture of the entire project as in goes like this, that you have a GUI, which is the presentation layer, which connects to the HTTP protocol when it will be web-based, which has JSP and AJAX that is needed to show you the interface on the web browser, which goes to the Java classes that are different for raise hand, attendance and all these others, where in the backend Python basically runs to transfer the packets across the hardware and the receiver which is there. So Python everywhere is working in the backend basically to unpack the packets which have been received, which basically contains the actual data or the information. We have the database which is in form of MySQL. You are storing all that data. That will be on the server of IITB once it has been designed in the web-based model. For the remote location also, in the remote center, you'll have a instructor machine where the receiver will be connected, and Python will be responsible for communication within the classroom environment from the hardware to the receiver, and the receiver will then send the information to the server at IITB through the web browser and the web-based application. For the particular Python serial utility, the code flow diagram is like this, that you only have one executable file, that's pythonintegration.py, which in turn imports all these various modules like Clicker config, Clicker attendance, Clicker sensing, Clicker raise hand and Clicker quiz. They are all being imported, which has all the message definitions of how are you supposed to send and receive packets. The main def is one file which is calling Clicker config attendance according to a user manual. There is a menu which comes and you'll be asked to enter the choice that you want to take. SDef is secondary definitions. There are some particular functions like ones complement, twos complement and getting the checksum, etc., which have been defined here. And GPV is the main module which imports all the other packages like serial, time, array in different forms. The data flow for attendance is like, you have attendance as an entity, and in Clicker configuration is one thing that is required before each and every process that we do. In Clicker config, it will send you the attendance will send the NOC and RC to Clicker config, and Clicker config in turn will send you the acknowledgement that it has received it. The course ID and the Clicker ID will also be given by the user, and the acknowledgement for that will also be sent. Then when you go to the attendance part, it will just ask you that do you want to take attendance, and if you press yes, it will collect the attendance and it will send you an acknowledgement on your hardware as well. And the XML file for all the clickers will also be generated in the backend. For the quiz, you see we need clicker config, sensing and quiz. These are three things that we need. In config, again, the same thing is there, like you will give the course IDs, clicker IDs, question type, time number. All this will be given by the user in this particular utility that we have given so that he can test for different things, whatever he wants. And then an acknowledgement will be sent. In SendSync, it is basically initializing the clickers for starting with the quiz process. And then in the quiz, it will ask you to collect the quizzes and it will send the responses. Like if you have the correct answer as B to a question and different students have pressed different answers, all those answers and the time taken by each student to answer those questions will be stored in an XML file which will be generated by the clicker quiz function. The last one is a raise hand, which is again an entity which requires clicker config, and then if you press that you want a raise hand process to follow, actually this is a long process which will always be running in the background because a student can have doubt at any time. So as soon as there is some student who has pressed hand, an acknowledgement will be sent back to the receiver on the instructor machine, and that particular student ID who has pressed the raise hand will again be stored in XML, and all these XML files are basically going to the web or going to the desktop application for processing further. The actual implementation is shown here. It doesn't have a nice GUI interface because it's something to be used by the testing team. So if you do a configuration, it initially asks you that configure the hardware, and that is particularly for the sudo command, the shell script basically, that is integrated into Python now. Then you are asked to enter the course ID, which is very weird here, and NOC, RC, and the number of clickers. The number of clickers is basically the number of students in a classroom. Like if there are 200, you can write 200, and then it will go through the process of configuration and will show you that finally the ask for NOC and RC has been received, and you'll have the menu again. Like the four options of the menu will come again. Then if you want to do an attendance, you will press the choice will be 1, and then this kind of a file will be generated, which has in this, you can see Clicker ID 2 is having Z rather than X, because Clicker ID 2 was present on that day. For quiz again, the user will be asked to enter the question time, question number, the question type, the correct answer and all these things. And then a timer will run accordingly. You have given 10 seconds, a timer of 10, 9, 8, 7, 6 will run till 10 seconds. And by that time, if somebody has given a response, like clicker number 2 has given a response E and he has taken 5 seconds for doing that, that is generated in the XML file. With this, we end with the Python serial utility, and I'll hand over to explain the answer.
When you send acknowledgement, when the student raises hand, you did not show acknowledgement going to the student clicker as well.
So that raise hand button, there is a hand like button which also comes on the clicker. That means your data has been received. Hand. So both ways, acknowledgement is always being sent.
Yeah, otherwise, the student will keep pressing.
Keep
that.
Pressing. Yeah.
Good morning, all of you. My task is given as creating a GUI installer to install the packages like JRE, Python, along with the Clicker remote software. Before explaining this GUI installer, I will tell you what made us to go for this GUI installer. Earlier, before developing this Clicker GUI installer, there are two modes of installations. One is online mode and second one is offline mode. In the online mode, we will install Clicker remote software through sudo commands like sudo apt-get install, like Python and JRE. By all those commands, we install Clicker remote software in remote centers. But it is a time-taking process, and it's creating some dependency problems in user machines. If you take offline mode, you have to download the entire packages, .dv packages or .bin packages, and you have to write a commands in, and you should execute the shell script in terminal. It is also one time-taking process. That's why we have gone for shell script. Shell script which installs the Clicker remote software in remote centers, but shell script is working properly, but it's not that much user-friendly. That's why I have gone for GUI installer. GUI installer is like any installer, but it's completely wizard-based interface. It installs the Clicker remote software along with the packages, JRE, Python, Python serial in remote centers. And it's completely user-friendly when compared with shell script or online, offline modes of installation. And throughout the installation, users feel completely very comfortable while dealing with this remote installer, and a non-technical person can understand very easily while installing this Clicker remote software in remote centers. You can show, you can see the design of GUI installer. The GUI installer in such a way that after clicking this setup file, it should check for whether JRE is already installed in our machine or not. Whether JRE is installed or not. If it is already installed, we need not to install it again in our machine. If it is already installed, it just discards the installation of JRE in user machine. Then it goes to installation of Python. The same case with Python also. If it is already installed, it will not install again. Then after the installation of JRE, after installation of JRE and Python, it will select the location of installation and it will finish the installation. You can see this is how the installation wizard looks like. It's showing the Java is not already installed, that's why it's showing Java 0. Then it goes to the installation of Python serial. After installing all Java, JRE and Python, the installation complete, it looks like this installation wizard looks like. And apart from that, it provides a very uninstallation tool which completely removes the desktop environment of Clicker remote software in remote machine.
Good morning all. We worked on open office integration feature. What is the utility of this? We have a separate desktop application. So we thought of implementing the open office into it so that it's not required for instructor to switch between the applications and work. So that is one of the reason why we implemented it. And we created an Clicker desktop application feature into the open office. Like once you open office, you will be displayed with an add-on where you can install, I mean, where you can take attendance and all those modules. So these three are the main things what we implemented. Creating new slide is like once you require a new question, you just have to go to this menu and create it. Inside new slide, we have different templates, and each one will produce a different template. And next is Clicker slideshow, also called a smart slideshow. So what happens here is it's something different from the normal slideshow. On each slide, it detects whether it's a quick slide or not. If it is a quick slide, it starts collecting response after the time is started. So this is automatically done. It's not required for the instructor to start collect response and all those. This monitoring tool is the main feature over here, where all the Clicker features have been implemented in it. So on the creating a new slide or creating new question, what happens is on selecting the question type, we have like yes or no, true or false and all those. So each layout is created based on it. So after creating the layout, we'll be prompted with properties, like what is the correct answer, which order is the correct answer. And all those properties are attached to the slide. So while slideshow, it is processed on the slide. And in Clicker slideshow, it's like the same thing what I told. Detects whether it's a quick slide or not. If not, it goes straight forward. Okay. And this is a monitoring tool. Here, Clicker configuration, these are the modules what we implemented in it. So Clicker configuration configures the Clicker with the configures the add-on with the Clicker. And attendance system is like take view attendance and all those modules. These features are implemented on presentation. So you start a presentation or instructor start a presentation, if you prompted with these any features, you can select anything. And in the raise hands, what happens exactly is a Python process is executed continuously through the slideshow. If someone has a raise hand, that gets added into a text file or an XML file. And we are just detecting if there is a change in a text file, it means a raise hand is interrupted. So we'll intimate the instructor by some alert, sound and image. And these are a few screenshots. This is the, say if you want to create an yes or no question, you'll be prompted something like this and you can enter the details. And these details are attached to the slide on the quiz slide. So the left is the monitoring tool, which will be displayed on slideshow. So click on the any button and corresponding tools will be created and you can always, this is the thing, the right side is almost there in the desktop application, which has implemented the code there. So polling and raise on the same features. While raise on, once you get a raise on or something, the monitoring tool will change into red and will start blinking until you see who has raised the hand. And this is how the layout looks. This is a no question. And the right side, what you see is the monitoring tool. That will be opacity will be decreased. Once you on mouse over, it gets automatically. So on the start timer, what happens is you can either do a manual entry of the time or fetch the time from the slide. Okay. On start timer alone, the options will be visible. It's like instructor wants to explain the question first, then start the timer. So only the question will be displayed on slideshow. So once you start the timer, the options will be displayed so that it's required for the collect responses at that time. So these are the response start. Okay. Well, that's all in open up. Thank you.
How long did it take for your team to figure out the open office code and to figure out the points where you need to make modifications?
Like, initially, we took some 3 weeks of sort of to see whether it's feasible or not. The feasibility report took a lot. After that, we got used to it within some couple of days because it's pure Java coding. So later on, it's like pure labor work.
Once again, good morning, everyone. Good morning, Prof, my mentors and my dear friends. I've been working on we have been working on Clicker V3, that is the web-based development of Clicker version 2, which was previously made. The first day I entered this institute, I asked my mentor, why version 3? Why do we require a web-based development of the software?
Then slowly and slowly when we were developing, I saw the version 2 people struggling with the installer, struggling with the operating system, struggling with the machine architecture. There is 62-bit, there is 32-bit, there are 64-bit. So we realized that this thing is OS independent, it's platform independent, it is architecture independent. So only thing is required is a web browser, which is almost present in every operating system. So here I'll just recapitulate some of the features which we have done right now. First is data availability and accessibility. That is, the instructor from anywhere in the world without installing any software utility, that will help to increase data availability and accessibility for the instructor and admin. We just need a browser and every functionality which was there in the version 2, each and every functionality. I think we implemented 4 modules. So we implemented 4 out of 6 modules. And then if data is exchanged with the server and the part of the web pages is updated without replacing the, without reloading the whole page. We use AJAX, that is asynchronous JavaScript, so that we can load the page without redirecting the user. There is an, we use the industry standard, which is a depth of 3. We are only using 3 web pages to redirect in a tree, depth wise. Then we provide an easy to use interface. We have implemented question bank, profile, viewing report, attendance, and quiz bank module. Viewing report, we use Jasper technology. When I was here, I didn't even heard what is a Jasper technology. My instructor told me, and we have got a beautiful user interface with a tabulated form of data, which will be very easy to interpret, and the reports are, for the developer, it's very easy to generate. We just have to write a query in the box and whole of the report will be generated on a standard template which belongs to our Clicker tool. There is the data flow diagram. It's a common login form which is always there. Then we have a profile module which is having CRUD operations for institution, department, coach and instructor. Admin can do all the 4 operations, that is creating, he can update it, he can delete it and he can add more. Then we have question bank module. Question bank module is we can add more and more questions to a question bank which already exists. We have, last time we didn't have that picture thing. Now we have also a picture associated to a question. So we can have a photograph or something attached to that. We can add 2 to 5 options to a one question. Then we have this admin page. Which I have already shown in the data flow diagram, we can perform those 4 operations. So this is the admin page where the admin will log in and you can see the 4 operations there: new, add, delete, update, and reset is to make the things blank. We have this as the question bank thing. You can set the level of difficulty, what is the course category, what is the question type, and we can type the question and add options with that option. So we can have everything which was there in the version 2 in version 3. This is adding options. All the options will be displayed here, and when I click add new options, another div will come, which is not there right now. So another div will come which will show you those parameters which are required, and we will submit it at the end of, when the user submits the question. Then we have the Jasper reports, as I told you. We can generate reports and we can view it on the web browser. Here we can do all the functionality which are there in a PDF file. So this is the Jasper report. That's it. I'll ask Megha to give the conclusion.
Thank you all. Finally, to conclude with, I would like to again summarize all the 4 tasks that have been successfully completed by our team. That is the interaction or sending and receiving of packets, that is the actual data using the Python, the GUI installer, which has been successfully implemented, which installs and uninstalls all the packages automatically, the Clicker applications which have been integrated into OpenOffice, and the development of 3 has been changed to 5 now, so 5 modules. These are the following references, a little help from the internet that we also can work. And this was always very less, so the internet is always very less actually to work with, as per se. So thank you, and our greatest regards and gratitude to our mentors who have helped us so much. Mr. Tushar Kambli is not here. Mr. Manjur, Mr. Rajavel, and Mr. Gobi, they have been very helpful, and we all had a great time. We learned a lot, and we thank you, sir, that you gave us this opportunity to be here. Thank you.